Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. In this video we'll see how to check particular port is opened or not in a remote machine using Python. I'll be using library called socket. So this library is by default available in Python. We can verify that. First I'll go to Python, then I'll type help. Modules. Here you will be able to see the module socket. Now to see the details of socket, help give socket. You can see the details of socket here, and you can see this module provides socket operations. Now I'll come out of this. We'll see the documentation of socket here. Can see this module provides socket interface, and it is available for Unix, Windows and macOS. And if we come down here, we can see the address families. We'll be using the address family AF underscore INET. INET is for IPv4, and here you can see two values we'll be using. One is host and port. Host can be either a fully qualified domain name or IPv4 address, and port is going to be an integer. So first in this script I'll import the module socket. Import socket. Then we'll see one of the sample code here. Yeah, you can see two sets of codes here. One is server program and another is client program. Socket can either act as server or client. In our case, we are going to use it as a client because we are going to check the connectivity of a remote server. Even you can listen to particular port using this. So you can see here the address family is IPv4 and socket we are using is sockstream. Sockstream we use for TCP connections. So I'll copy this. And I'll create an object here. I'll give a name device underscore socket. And using this device socket, we need to connect to a device. So I'll give a name for that. The result of this connection. So I'll call this as result of check. I'm giving this name for us to understand. You can give any name here, and I'll be using the above socket connection dot and connect. We'll see the details of connect here. There is multiple methods. We'll search connect underscore ex. Yeah, we can see if you use connect method, it will connect to a remote socket at an address. And if you give connect ex, it instead of raising an exception, it returns an error. So we'll see both. First I'll try using connect. Connect here, either we need to give IP address and port number, or we can define a variable here. I'll call this variable destination equals, and I'll give the IP address 192.168.0.10, and port number I'm going to scan is 443. And here now I can give this variable destination. Now if you need to get the result, okay, let me try printing the result here. Print result of check. Let's try executing this script. Here you can see we have received none. Now let's try connecting to non-listening port 44. So here terminal is waiting for the timeout. So what we can do is we can set a default timeout. We'll search how to set that. So this is how we can set the timeout. Set the default timeout in seconds float. That means it'll accept even decimal values. Let's try setting it. I'll give half second. Now let me try executing it. You can see I'm getting an exception because this host is not listening to port 44. Now let's try with connect underscore ex. Ex will not throw an exception. Let's see. So ex is giving a number 11. Now let's try with the connecting listening port. You can see I'm getting 0. That means when I use connect underscore ex method, it gives 0 when it is success. So let us try with another host 0.1, and my 0.1 is listening on port 80. You can see I'm getting 0, but if I give 801, I'll get another number. So what we'll do, we can just write an if statement here. If result of check equal to 0, then I'll print listening on port. And in the end, we'll close the connection. So db socket dot close, and we'll write an else statement here. Else print, I'll say is not listening on port. Now we'll close the connection here also. Now let's try printing it. You can see it is printing now is not listening on port. Here I'll use single quote itself. Both are same, but to maintain the consistency, I'll use single quotes. And this print we can remove. We'll test it with another host 443. You can see 443 is listening on port. 0.10 is listening on port 443. Now, but if you want to test multiple hosts at a time, you cannot do with this code. So we'll use function. Function will help to reuse the code. So what we can do is we'll define a function here. Define. I'll give the name port check, and inputs are going to be IP address and port number. And we'll move this below the function. And here now we don't need this variable. Here we'll give a print statement. Print. I'll give a new line slash n started executing script, and one more new line, and here since we are giving IP and port as input, here also we need to change it. Here we'll give that IP comma port number. And now to scan multiple devices, we can just call this function. I'll copy this. I'll put it here and it'll give the IP address. IP is 192.168.0.10. Port number is 80. And I'll give 443 here. And for 0.1, port 80 and port 801. So let's try executing it. You can see here it is printing listening on port or is not listening on port. It is not printing any other details. So now what we'll do, we'll take these variables and add it in the print statement so that we can see which host is listening and which host is not listening. So what we'll do here inside print statement, we'll give string of IP plus and we'll give a space here. So is listening on port and we'll give the port number as well. Now let's try printing it. So you can see here now it prints even IP address also. You can see 0.10 is listening on port 80. So we'll add a space here. Similar way we'll add for not listening also. Okay, let's try executing it again. Yeah, you can see here it printed properly. Now here also we can do, so here in the end we'll add one more print for after finishing the script. So what we'll do, we'll add a new line first, slash n plus then hash into 50 plus and we'll copy this and let's paste it here. So this slash and we can remove. Let's try executing it. So you can see here now it shows started executing in a separate section. Similar way in the end also we can give. Finished executing script. So you can see here the message properly. In the next video we'll see how to scan range of ports of remote machine and how to get FQDN and how to resolve hostname instead of IP we'll give hostname, and we'll see how to handle those errors like if it is not able to resolve the hostname, all these things. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.